We got freedom to gain, we feed them the game. Turn on new freedom exchange, we freeing your brain. They trying to shackle your mind, no half of us blind. Remember the past, but never go backwards in time. The ancestors lived through us to help us build a model community. New Africa is soon to be. So tune in to Sister Marsha, Mujahideen, Imam Bilal, to get your cultural enlightenment now.
Welcome back to another edition of New Freedom Exchange, your cultural expression for social dignity and community empowerment. I'm your co-host, Mujahideen. Peace be upon you. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. It's Imam Bilal Hassan. We're live here on New Freedom Exchange podcast. Happy to be here. Happy to be with you all on this beautiful Saturday evening. And we ask everyone here to come into the chat. Please give salams or peace. Let us know where you're tuned in from so we can recognize you and shout you out. And also, if you are watching this on YouTube or on Facebook, please share the live stream to your family and friends now. Now will be a good time to do that because we have a great, great, great show with some with amazing guests on talking to us about an amazing and a very special project that we would like everyone, inshallah, God willing, to see. And to be a witness to this special project coming to life, God willing. Brother Deen, how's everything with you?
Everything is going well. Looking forward to tonight's show. It's actually a good precursor for us getting prepared for what we're calling it. We called it last year, actually, New Freedom February. We know a few years ago, we picked up the expression New Africa August, highlighting the future and New Freedom February, honoring the past. And so, this will be a great launch this week, and we have some going into next week. And so I'm looking forward to today's show. I think all of February, we're going to, you know, just keep pumping this effort going forward. I had a great time. On another note, real quick, checking. I had a great time in Baltimore on Friday with the boys, and it was good to see the believers down there, and they also gave us the greetings.
Excellent, excellent. Alhamdulillah. I am actually on the road too. Visiting my grandmother who is in rehabilitation facility. Inshallah, please, God willing, you know, make dua or supplication prayer as she recovers from illness, and may she also be given strength to be able to be mobile. More mobile than she is currently right now. But outside of that, I am actually very excited for this show. And I don't want to prolong. We don't want to prolong this because we want to really get to the meat and potatoes of what we have to present to you all tonight on this episode of New Freedom Exchange. And we have tonight with us talking about a short documentary on the life of the Honorable Clara Muhammad and the school system that was established by her, the University of Islam, which metamorphosized into the Clara Muhammad school system. And now also we have the W.D. Muhammad High School system as well in Atlanta, Georgia. So Clara Fruit is the name of the documentary. And today we are joined by the producer and the director, Morgan Mathews, Brother Morgan Mathews, and Sister Aidah Aliyah Rasheed is the producer. So inshallah, we can bring them on the screen at this point of time to give salams. Assalamu alaikum, everyone.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you all doing?
Doing well. Thank y'all for having us. Excited to be here. Excited for what y'all are doing. And thank you. Good to be here.
Oh, it's good. Good. Alhamdulillah. So as for all of our guests on our platform, we usually put forth a little mini challenge. To begin with, and that is, if you have, I would say 30 seconds, but I'm not gonna do that to you all. In 1 minute, if you were in the elevator, and someone asked, "Who is Morgan Mathews?" Brother Morgan Mathews, his sister Aidah Aliyah Rasheed, how would you answer that question?
30 seconds. Okay. When does the timer start?
Right now.
I would say, let's see, who is Morgan Mathews? I'm a believer. I'm a son, I'm a brother, I'm a husband, I'm a new father of a two-year-old, and I'm a storyteller in different mediums, but I really care about bringing forth narratives and painting pictures that help our communities reflect the best parts and the most challenging and complicated parts of ourselves in real and imagined worlds. I'll stop there before I keep rambling. So that's a little bit about me.
Go ahead, Sister Aidah. Inshallah.
Yeah, so who is Aidah Aliyah Rasheed? I am a believer, a servant, a mother, daughter, a sister, auntie, friend, a cousin. Also a storyteller, creative, someone who loves to capture and share light.
Excellent, excellent. I think you all nailed it in 30 seconds. Alhamdulillah, it's good. So now, talk to us. We want to know. We want to know the project that you all are working on, Clara's Fruit Project. What is it about? Well, let's stop here. Let's start here. This is better yet. Why a documentary on Sister Clara Muhammad? Why? Why? What was the inspiration behind that?
Yeah, great, great question. We can start there. I'll give a bit of context on the journey of how we got here to this project. So last year, when I moved back to Atlanta with my family, we were living in the Bay Area for about 6.5 years. When I moved back, I learned about this film grant opportunity through an organization called the Islamic Scholarship Fund that some folks may be familiar with, others, it's gonna be the first time hearing. The Islamic Scholarship Fund, they're an institution that's been around, I wanna say over a decade now, that does a lot of great initiatives across policy, media, scholarship, et cetera. So there's this open call to apply for a film grant to tell a story from, you know, a Muslim perspective. And I really wanted to tell the story about Sister Clara Muhammad, and particularly Muhammad Schools of Atlanta. I didn't go to the school, but I have family that's went to the school, close friends that have went to the school. And there's always been something as me being an observer or a witness of what the school has produced. As a storyteller, I'm like, I want to unpack that more. And so I applied to the grant with support from Aidah and our team to get the application in. And alhamdulillah, you know, a few months later, we learned that we received the grant. And so the reason that we find it, you know, vitally important to tell this story, I think on one side of the equation, you have Muslims and non-Muslims who may just have never heard about Sister Clara Muhammad. Maybe to us it's a little bit surprising, but in a lot of ways, on a large scale, this isn't a woman that's, you know, being taught in the public school system, or in many systems for that nature outside of our direct community. So in a lot of ways, it's like, okay, how do we, you know, be a part of shedding light onto something that has extreme significant impact to the legacy of not only Black Muslims in America, but Muslims in America, but also just the entire education system, given that, you know, she started one of the first, you know, kind of formalized homeschools in America that's, you know, recognized. And then secondly, from the perspective of, for our community, so many of us who have either gone through Clara Muhammad schools or University of Islam or W.D. Muhammad schools, really, you know, looking at this film as kind of a gift back to our communities of serving as somewhat of a reminder of, you know, what you have experienced and the beauty of the things that you experienced. And so really wanted to highlight those elements of just how important her work is, and we can, you know, dive into it more. But that's kind of where the foundation started, acknowledging how important it is to bring more of her story to light. Aidah, if there's anything else that I may have missed, feel free to.
No, I think that's it, Morgan. And I mean, one of the reasons why I was so excited about participating, and Morgan asked me to formally like come on board to participate and be a part of this project, it kind of felt like a divine alignment, because Dr. Zakiya Muhammad, who, like a lot of her final life's work before her death, was publishing a book about Sister Clara Muhammad, which he had actually reached out to Imam Morsi Muhammad, may Allah be pleased with him, and grant him to the highest station in paradise. She asked permission from Imam Morsi Muhammad to write the book about his mother, because originally he said, I want to write a book about my mother. So she waited and waited. And I think 20 years later, he asked him again, like, can I write this book? You know, do I have your permission? And he said, yes. He said, you have my permission to write the book. So, you know, I think that her life and the fact that I felt like she literally passed something on to me to do to help preserve the story and the legacy of Sister Clara Muhammad, this felt divinely aligned. And so I'm really grateful to be a part of the production team, being a producer on the film, and also just a support, and just to encourage, be an encouragement to Morgan and share resources and information and anything that I can to kind of help bring this to life. I feel like it's just a divine call and a divine assignment. So I'm just trying to submit and be of service.
Excellent, excellent. So building off of that, how has it been during this process? Can you describe to the viewers the process, a little bit of the process behind the accumulating the information about Clara Muhammad? And how's that been for you all during this period of time putting together this documentary, you know, with, you know, primary resources, secondary resources? You know, can you describe a little bit about the process that you all are undertaking right now to put together this amazing documentary?
Absolutely. Yeah. I start by saying the intention at the onset was to make it as much of a communal art-based project as we could, mainly because we know how tight-knit our communities are, and we also know how intergenerational our communities are. So how do we as storytellers, you know, kind of honor those two elements of what community-based storytelling, you know, could look like? And so because a lot of the emphasis of the film not only is on her life related to the school system, but really putting a microscope on the Atlanta community, particularly Muhammad Schools of Atlanta. Given that I live in Atlanta, I go to Atlanta Masjid of Al-Islam, which is directly integrated, you know, with the K-12 school that's not even a block down the street. A lot of it, you know, started with like just getting, you know, consensus amongst the community that, hey, this is a project that, you know, we want to, you know, back and support. When I learned that her granddaughter, Sister Halima, her great-grandson, Khalil Ali, both work at the school, Sister Halima being a teacher, Brother Khalil being the principal, and there's two other relatives. I don't want to butcher their names right now, so I'm not going to do that, but there's two other descendants that work at the school as well. So having conversations with them has been a part of this process. Aidah mentioned Dr. Zakiya Muhammad's book, Mother of the Nation, that we've been reading. There's some published papers from PhDs that we've been taking in, but really just making sure that we are a part of the community in gathering information about the story as well. One side note, there's a brother who, his name is Brother Hassan, Brother Hassan Sharif. He has been documenting from a video perspective the Atlanta community for the past 55 plus years. And there's another brother, Nassar, who's been photographing the community for the past 50, 60 plus years. And both of them are in Atlanta. Both of them are part of the Atlanta Masjid community. And so even being in conversation with them related to the archive has been very powerful, because just that access to footage from like the 80s and the 70s, even, you know, with Imam Muhammad, that probably may have not been seen since that time. So things of that nature have been a big part of just our gathering to get information for the film.
Excellent, excellent. Sister Aidah, you want to add to that? Are you good?
Well, I just want to, you know, really honor the hard work and efforts that Morgan has been taking to just strive to do this all with dignity and honor and excellence. There has been a lot of conversations that we had at the beginning, you know, just trying to find information. And then it kind of, Morgan and I were working on another project outside of this prior to this project. And so when he started, I started sharing a little bit more about my connections with people. And then I think Morgan was like, wait a minute, I think you're someone that, you know, could really be of service. And so it just naturally, things just started coming out. Naturally, I just started to connect with folks and pass people along to Morgan, and learning about other systems that are in place within our community that I feel like is kind of a secret. Like, a lot of people don't know how interconnected, almost like a spider web, you know, our communal associations are within California, you know, West Coast, East Coast, and then the Midwest. There is this really beautiful interconnectedness that we have. And I oftentimes don't feel like we're always aware of how interconnected we are, but also how much resources, like, we just have a wealth of knowledge and information and resources by individuals who have been a part of our historical communal legacy. And it just feels so, I'm just so excited and grateful that Morgan has been taking such interest and doing all his due diligence to tap into our communal network to gain as much inside information as he can, but particularly in Atlanta, which has been a real blessing to kind of watch how things are blossoming.
Alhamdulillah. I just want to use this quick moment to also share that, you know, it's Aidah not here today, but our team consists of three other producers and as well as a camera department and other departments. But our three other producers are Rashad, Mubarak, Nia Omer, and Love Soleil. So I just wanted to shout them out as well, as the efforts have come from all different angles to get us to this point, and for more to come.
I'm glad you mentioned that, Brother Morgan, because a lot of people may not be aware of what it takes to put together a project like this. Mm-hmm. And to have a team is very important to putting together a documentary. So I'm glad that you mentioned that you do have more team members. Mm-hmm. So absolutely. Thank you for mentioning that. The other question I want to transition to now is talk a little bit more about the project itself. A little bit more about the project itself, as it relates to what people might be seeing right now with the Seed Spark campaign. Mm-hmm. Can you explain to us, those who are watching and those who will watch this replay later, a little bit later on, about the campaign, and we'll get into the rollout or the future, what the future may hold, inshallah, for the project.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Just so I'm clearly understanding. So share more about just the film itself, and then also yes. about the campaign.
Yes. Got it.
Yeah, so the film itself is intended to be a blend of kind of this historical look back at the impact of Sister Clara Muhammad and her role within Muslim education in America. You know, building the University of Islam back in the early 30s out of a homeschool system, then moving to Chicago, then meeting, you know, her and her family and all their children moved to Chicago. At this time, you know, Temple Number 2 was like the focus area of Chicago within the Nation of Islam. And then that grew into, you know, different schools that stretched across, you know, Washington, D.C. and a couple other cities. And then fast forward, at its peak, there were over, say, around 50 plus schools across the entire country. And you're really looking at, you know, an environment of primarily Black, you know, Muslim students being not only taught things from a, you know, scholarship level of what all kids are being taught in K-12 systems, but also learning about their faith, also learning about Islam, also learning about how to read Quran and learn the Arabic language. So that's a big, that's an element of the film where we're like really just highlighting, okay, what did her vision, what did this vision that Sister Clara Muhammad have produced? But then the other half of the film, not necessarily in a linear order, but the other half of the film is really talking about Muhammad Schools of Atlanta, it being unique because I would say, unfortunately, that peak of 50 plus schools, that doesn't currently exist, right, in present day in terms of that volume of schools. And so we really wanted to highlight Muhammad Schools of Atlanta because it is a K through 12 system. It is very integrated, you know, with the masjid that's right down the street. And she has descendants from her bloodline that work at the school. So that from a storytelling perspective is extremely unique. And so looking at what is the day-to-day kind of flow of the school look like, and blending in some very creative, artful elements that I don't want to give away too much, but there will actually be some like scripted fictional moments within the film that we're just going to have a little bit more fun from like a stylized perspective. So this doesn't feel like just another documentary. I'll say it, I'll leave it as that. And in terms of the crowdfunding, so as you mentioned, you know, it's not easy, an easy endeavor to make a film, no matter what type of film it is, a short film, a feature length film, fiction, nonfiction. And especially for independent artists, meaning like we're not backed by some big studios or some, it's grassroots in that sense. And so we're using this platform called Seed and Spark, where you essentially get a time window to raise money for a film. And this time window we put on ourselves is 30 days to raise $18,000. And alhamdulillah, we've made a lot of progress. In the past 3.5 weeks, we've raised over $15,000. So we're about 2.5K away from meeting our goal. And there's also the option of the platform to exceed your goal. So the idea is that, you know, we exceed the goal and that will give us the funds to continue making the documentary. And then there'll be some other information a bit later about just other resources we'll need to not only finish the documentary, but to make sure that people see it and get the word out there. And we want to travel and have screening events and stuff like that. But so that's, I know I kind of maybe went a little long with it, but that's kind of the nature of it.
No, that was awesome. That was awesome. Appreciate you unpacking that. We do have our other co-host. She wasn't able to make it, but she do give you the salams. Assalamu alaikum, Morgan, Aidah. My apologies for not being with you today. I'm looking forward to Clara's Fruit. The Clara Muhammad School Networks will be in the building, inshallah.
Inshallah.
And as was mentioned, here is the link here. We put it up on the screen, seedandspark.com/fund/Clara's Fruit. So make sure you check. We're going to knock that 25 out tonight. 2,500, knock it out tonight.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do
it. Share and subscribe. We also want to give a shout out to Sister, we just met her in Baltimore, Sister Jamila Malik. She gives you the greeting, Sister Aidah. She shared with us that you all, I think, shared school together when she was in Morgan State, I believe.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's right.
I'm a divine alignment. So,
Yeah. That's my second home right there. That's a special place for me, for sure.
I was going to ask about the goals after, inshallah, after the project is funded, which we are speaking to existence, that will be funded. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to God, that this project will get funded.
Inshallah.
And I will give my usual spiel that I tell everyone on this platform who comes, that it's time to open up your checkbooks, but I will save that. I'll save that for the last second or so. But can you all talk about give us a little overview about the long-term goals that you all have with the Clara's Fruit documentary rollout, if that's okay?
Yeah, absolutely. So we've kind of addressed two of the goals, but I'll be explicit about them. One, it's, you know, addressing this need of really exposing and shedding light on what I call even the limited exposure of the impact that Black Muslims have had on this country, that Black Muslims have had on the trajectory of Islam over the years. So really addressing that need to fill a gap that many of us are closing, but I think there could always be more efforts, you know, to close those gaps. Number two is the continuing of preserving legacy. And I say continuing because we are not the first to preserve this legacy by any means. We're not the second, we're not the third, we're not even the 10th. Like, we're just a continuation of a legacy being preserved in our generation, right? I think that's the beautiful part of this story. That's the beautiful part of storytelling in general, that it really should be intergenerational. And we're just, you know, on this side of the generations that are preserving this legacy. And then the other two goals are, one is community engagement. So what's been amazing to see, and shout out to our producing team for our social media efforts, is we have got and gained a lot of just like love through social media. I mean, Aidah has a number of just relationships that she's built over the years. Rashad has a number of relationships, Nia as well, love, where, you know, we've reached out to different organizations like Sapelo Square or Black Muslim Girl Fly or The Flowers Podcast, many others that I can't name all because I'm going to forget somebody. But we've been able to reach out to individuals and organizations for that communal engagement part. And when the film is complete, we'd like to see that at a bigger level where, you know, we're partnering with alumni associations related to the school. We're partnering with the Clara Muhammad Schools Network. We're partnering with organizations like you all to really have in-person screenings that are paired with some version of a talk back, not just with our team, but alumni and staff who have gone through the Clara Muhammad Schools. As I mentioned earlier, Sister Halima, granddaughter of Honorable Elijah Muhammad and Sister Clara Muhammad. She is the daughter of the youngest of the siblings, the youngest daughter. And having her be a part of screening events where we can listen directly from her, right? That would be a beautiful thing. So number three, community engagement. And then number four is educational impact, right? So what does it look like to have this film be a part of, this is an idea Aidah shared with me some time ago, but what is it like for the film to be in partnership with like curriculum development, where this is now in higher education institutions, like religious studies programs, or even in K-12, right? Like interfaith conversations that both public schools and private schools could be a part of. So Aidah, I don't know if you want to share more on that kind of concept that we're talking about, but feel free.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, as an educator myself, someone who's worked in both private and public schools, and I've worked in the nonprofit sector, Clara's Fruit is just such a great, it's inshallah, once the film is complete and finished, it's going to be such an amazing resource. And so, you know, I've done museum education work, like it would be a great resource to have when there's exhibitions happening around the history, like at the Smithsonian Museum, for instance, has a really beautiful exhibition, like a permanent part of their collection that you can see today. You can go there and see information about our communal history and stories. And so I would love to see Clara's Fruit being screened at the Smithsonian National Museum of African American History and Culture. More conversations, because I think that we're living in a time where it's just such a ripe time to talk more about the history of Islam in America, but particularly the Muslim community in America, which it just seems that there has not been a very thoughtful effort to properly educate our American society about the history of Muslims in America. So people fear Muslims, people fear the religion of Islam because they just don't know anything about it. And maybe what they have heard has been not the most positive, you know. So I think that it's time that we talk more and educate more of general population, you know, about our communal history and stories, and also the impact that our community has had. I mean, over decades, you know, there's just so many individuals have done so many things that we just don't know about or we don't talk about. And so it is time for a new generation, and also those who are from, you know, older generations who started organizations or Islamic schools who don't know anything about the history, right, within our own community. There's a story, I won't name the institution, but I was at an educational institution of higher learning in the Muslim community, and someone walked through my office doors who started a Muslim institution, and I asked the sister, you know, do you know about Sister Clara Muhammad? And she's like, no, I don't. And I just kind of didn't worry, I wasn't wearing any pearls, but like I was just kind of grasping my chest, like I can't believe that, you know, someone who has started their own Islamic educational institution in American society, in a progressive community, you know, doesn't know anything about the history of Sister Clara Muhammad. And so that is, I would say, probably more common than we think, unfortunately, in our Muslim American community. And so, you know, the educational goals, as Morgan was speaking about, which is creating curriculum, having lesson plans, just really allowing for more communal engagement after the film is created, that is, you know, such a high priority. And I'm so grateful and thankful, as Morgan mentioned, how we've been able to connect with different organizations and institutions that have kind of led us to different options and possible opportunities to do a lot of impact work once the film is finished. So that's exciting to see how this will live and breathe and be a part of our, just to be in the world and just to see what happens. But we pray all will be good. And yeah, it's exciting to see what just to envision the possibilities of what can come about.
Yeah. Alhamdulillah. I mean, this is amazing. I'm very excited. We are very excited for this project, for this documentary. We have some comments. Also, don't forget, okay, SeedSpark. SeedandSpark.com/fund/ Clara's -fruit, -fruit. Definitely, please do what you can to help this communal effort to come into fruition. This is for us, by us, produced by us. And you get no better than this. No, there's nothing better than this. Your own is producing. And we are asking the people, those who are watching now and those who watch later, inshallah, God willing, to open up your heart and be willing to support this endeavor. And as mentioned, it is important that we preserve our history. It is important that we preserve particularly what is special about our community's history is that we have elders who have sacrificed so much and paved the way so much for us to be in the places that we are, for us to be here today. So if you can, go to seedandspark.com. The link is there. The link is in the comments. And give what you can. I have so many ideas. And you know, Sister Marsha, you know, her head is spinning as always. She always got some ideas. She said, let's connect. I'm a board member for the Clara Muhammad School Networks, and we have great work happening for those post-film efforts. Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, and New Freedom Network is here as well. Yeah. New Freedom Exchange will definitely support you all in the efforts. And we have a lot of efforts that and relationships in this community that could really make this event this documentary a success. You talk about curriculums. Here in New York City, they just unraveling the Black Studies curriculum in the public school system. Mm-hmm. You know, so we have resources, we have connections in some of these cities that we need to really put forth what our contribution is. They're not going to do it for us. Mm-hmm. They're not going to do it for us. In fact, they're waiting for us to come with this kind of information. They're waiting. Mm-hmm. And no better person to tell it than our community to tell our history. So inshallah, please support this an effort, Clara's Fruit. Let's bring it to life and let's support them, inshallah.
I also wanted to mention too. Oh, no, go ahead, brother.
No, I was just gonna say quality production. We have a little
quality.
That ain't just the, you know, the guy on the corner with the iPhone and all that stuff. I mean, I'm a little butting for talking myself, but this is the real deal, top notch.
Yes, thank you. Morgan was saying we're not shooting it on an iPhone. This is a real crew production, very professional.
And not knocking iPhone films, just to be clear. You got to shoot your film on an iPhone, go listen. Do what you got to do, honestly.
Do what you got to do, for real. But it's alhamdulillah, we're really grateful that we have someone like Morgan who is an incredible storyteller and filmmaker. And I really encourage folks, I'll drop in the chat so we can share some of his director's reel and also one of his prior films, Half Day. Amazing, amazing work. I mean, he's a true storyteller, for real. Like, he's not playing games. But one thing that I wanted to just also highlight and share is, and I've been bringing this up in conversations in the past about, the Pew Research Studies has collected a lot of data, and it's not a secret that Islam is projected to become the second largest religion in American society within the next 25 years. And so there will be, Christians and then Muslims, and then, the other religions will come, religious groups will be a part of that, data point, I guess you could say. And so I'm just so, I understand now why there has been such a strong campaign to demonize Muslims and the religion of Islam, because there may be people afraid and fearful of what that looks like, right, in our American society, of what does it look like to just have more Muslims in our American society. And, and so this is, again, why I think it's so important that we do, within our community, understand it's our community, our responsibility to tell our story, to tell our, to not be a footnote in someone else's history book, which I often quote that by Imam Zaid Shaker. He was always advocating and reminding me of this. Like, you don't want to be a footnote in someone else's history book. You want to tell your stories, your own communal history and stories and legacies. And so I think this is all the more reason why we do need to support efforts like this and understand if we don't do it, who else is going to? I just wanted to make sure I say that out loud as well.
And I just want to thank you for sharing that, Aidah. I just want to follow up with one thing as well. As you mentioned, I've been sharing this with folks over the past, a couple of months in relation to this film, but also just in relation to my interest and passion for the arts. And I had an old college professor, his name was Dr. Carr, Howard, who shared in context related to our Black folks in America that, as Black people, we have to fight our way into history. And it's one of those quotes where you have to sit with for a small moment, like you have to fight your way into history. What does that actually mean? And I think there's a couple of ways to look at it, but what really comes to mind is that if we are not intentional about preserving our culture, our heritage, because of whether it be outside forces or because of apathy, right? Apathy towards like just being numbed by all the stimuli we get on a daily basis of technology, of like new flashy things, of things that are taking us away from our deen. If we're not intentional about that, then we are not going to be in any history records, right? Like if Sister Clara's family or Dr. Zakiya Muhammad or others weren't intentional about, documenting parts of her life, we wouldn't have anything to reference right now. And that's just, a handful of individuals, right? And so I think for us, as we're sitting here, not only talking about Clara's Fruit, but also it's like a call to action for people to just think more about the value of arts and culture in relation to community building. Because I think sometimes arts and culture gets looked at as this like fun thing on the side, almost. Not everybody, but I think sometimes it can be looked at. It's not like this, financial investment or this like financial vehicle that's about to like make everybody like X, Y, and Z. But in terms of just think about 30 years from now, when your children or grandchildren don't have a reference point to something that our pioneers did 20, 30 years ago. And if we're not intentional about like keeping it fresh on our minds, then it's going to literally be erased. Like, it's that simple. And so I just want to emphasize that in terms of, again, not just Clara's Fruit, but why our community just needs to also emphasize and support arts and cultural initiatives, different parts of, you know, just everywhere. So just wanted to say that.
No, that's awesome. You're about to get me fired up on that one, because that's what we talk about. We, in some of our community development work, we use cultural, our cultural heritage as a cornerstone for economic development and social dignity. And so definitely want to unpack that as we post-production. But we do want to play the trailer. We do have a quick campaign trailer. We want to play that and then come back on, read the comments, and get some closing remarks. If you don't mind, we'll be right back.
As a new dad, my wife and I are in constant conversation about the future of our child's education and what that might look like. As a family that identifies as Black, Muslim, and deeply rooted and invested in how community life impacts the school system, we really have to think about our options. But as a storyteller and filmmaker, I also have to think about the what ifs. Like, what if this was 1930 and we were part of the Great Migration from the South to the Midwest to a place like Detroit? What if we only had the option of putting our son into discriminatory public schools that treat him like a less than citizen? Or what if we were threatened with arrest for simply wanting to homeschool our child? Well, guess what? These what ifs are much truer than you can even imagine. And myself and our team were on a journey of documenting that. Welcome to Clara's Fruit. Clara's Fruit is a short poetic documentary about the 90-year legacy of Clara Muhammad, an unsung pioneer in America's education system. In 1932, Clara started America's first Muslim homeschool that evolved into over 40 private schools across the country. And the beauty of this story is that today, with only a handful of those schools remaining, her great-grandson Khalil serves as the principal of the school in Atlanta that I'm sitting in right now, where K through 12 students are able to freely learn about their faith, culture, and futures. My name is Morgan Mathews, and I'm an Atlanta-based filmmaker. And there are a couple of reasons why my team and I want to share is vitally important to bring Clara's Fruit to life. Number one, our hope is to amplify her work so that her labor and influence never go unnoticed. Words like vision, perseverance, and resilience come to mind when we think about Clara Muhammad. Additionally, we see her as a vehicle into learning more about the history of Islam in America and how it's interwoven into the fabric of building this country. And number two, our K-12 education system has been in a crisis. When you consider factors such as teacher shortages, lack of resources, bullying, and a list of others, we really wanted to shine a light on what we consider a model example of where community life and educational life work hand in hand together. This film is currently being supported by the Muhammad Schools of Atlanta Alumni Association and the Islamic Scholarship Fund. Their support has gotten us to 25% of our budget, and now we're asking our community to help us close that gap. So with all that said, I invite you to join us on this journey. On this journey of making a film, on this journey of amplifying the voice of an unsung hero, and the journey of preserving history. Thank you.
There you have it. There you have it. Again, Clara's Fruit, seedandspark.com/fund/Clara's- What are you calling that? Is that a, what is that?
Hyphen.
Correctly, thank you. Hyphen Fruit. And you'll be able to see that video as well to share with your friends and family and your colleagues and also support. We want to clock in, knock it out that 2500 tonight. God willing, the next 24 hours, help them out. So we'll read some comments, and then we'll get you all's last remarks. What are the people saying? The people are saying, Assalamu alaikum, that's Sister Yasmin. She'll give you the greetings. Who else we got right here? I saw our editor. She gave some comments earlier as well. Where did it go? Oh, here she go. She says, thank you for the fruit, but remember how Sister Clara plowed the ground, starting one of the first homeschooling systems in the African-American community. You all just highlight that very excellently. So we thank you for that. I'm sure you probably gave this shout out. Brother Ollie from Richmond, Virginia.
Right. And my Marsha and our sister, dear beloved sister Marsha, is so excited behind that screen right now. She's ready to jump off out the screen at us. Alhamdulillah. And before we let y'all go, you know, I heard Howard and Morgan State is in the building. Is that correct? Do we have that correct?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Okay. HBCUs are in the building. Lincoln right here representing Lincoln. I know Sister Marsha will say the HU in the chat in a second, because she's.
I would say it too, but she probably pulled me off screen.
But she went time out. No, this is alhamdulillah. This is wonderful. So, brother Morgan or sister Aida, whoever wants to go first, give us some closing remarks, inshallah.
Go ahead, Aida.
I think Morgan, you know, again, I'm grateful and I'm thankful. We just come from a very beautiful and blessed communal legacy, and I'm just so grateful and thankful to be called to serve in this way, you know, to be of service. And I just pray that folks see value in the story, folks invest and see, you know, that the need to make sure that our communal stories and histories are preserved. And, you know, to just ask folks to keep us in your good opinion and prayers. That's the best thing that we can really ask for folks, because I know that there are people questioning what we're doing. I know that there's, you know, the history is complicated and it's difficult. It's not always easy. And I know we're sharing, talking about so much beauty, but I'm recognizing that there is beauty in truth telling. There's beauty in the discomfort, you know, that can come with bringing up the past, because not everyone has warm, fuzzy feelings about the past. You know, and so I think it's just important that as we're on this journey, that folks, again, keep us in your good opinion and prayers. And if you are able to donate, please do so. If you're able to share the link with those that you know and love, and we pray that Allah, you know, is pleased with our efforts.
Inshallah. Yeah, I second everything Aida shared. Closing remarks. Thank you all. Thank you and your team for having us. Thank you for the time. Thank you for the people that tuned in. We're just going to keep making du'as on this journey and keep thinking big. I think that's what we've realized on this journey. And that's why it's so beautiful to have a team where you can have people to counterbalance ideas and thoughts and strategies and approaches. And it's like, oh, we can't do that. No, we can do that, right? So I think that's been a beautiful part of this experience. And please reach out to us. Our Instagram page is clarasfruit.doc. That's clarasfruit.doc. We're pretty active on there. And just so y'all know, a timeline of things, once the crowdfunding is complete, we're intending to go back into production like mid-February. That was always the goal because we didn't want to be filming during Ramadan, which is supposed to be early March. Inshallah, we get across this goal with the community's support, and we can make a movie. So.
To my knowledge, you guys are still having call-outs, right? I think I saw a post for people who were alumni.
Yeah, that. Thank you for bringing it up. Forgot to mention that. So alongside the documentary, we are also informally building an audio archive of alumni, students. Because I know everybody can graduate from Claremont Schools or Muhammad Schools, but somebody might have went there for a couple of years, and staff as well. So we're collecting like 1 to 2 minute audio reflections that we're posting on the social media page. And we're going to be doing that, you know, until people stop, basically. And so if you've ever gotten a random, you know, message from me asking to submit an audio message, just know where that intention is coming from. So, but yeah, thank you for mentioning that.
No doubt.
Excellent. So we have come to the end. We don't want you to let you all go, but we have to. But it was such a great conversation, and very important points that came up. So our last reminder is for everyone to go to Instagram. If you have, go to clarasfruit.doc to check it out, their socials. But most importantly, also to go to seedandspark.com and go ahead and learn more about the project and put some money towards it, inshallah. Whatever counts, $5, $10, $25, $50, $75, $100, is whatever you can afford to give at the moment, because no dollar is going to be turned around, inshallah, God willing. So please do that and help us make this project come into fruition, come into life, so we can all benefit. Humanity is going to benefit from this, not just this immediate community that bared Clara Fruit, that did give birth to, pun intended, that did give birth to all of us, in a sense, indirectly and directly, in terms of her contributions. But for humanity at this time to understand the importance of Sister Clara Muhammad's contributions means a lot, especially as Sister Aidah put it so beautifully and gracefully about the times that we're living in. The times that we're living in socially and politically, it is a time where this can be a very much benefit and a dawah for those who may not know anything about Islam or may be ignorant to Islam. And here is a story that people can relate to, that represents humanity. It represents people who are humble and people who are about to struggle and put in time, blood, sweat, and tears to establishing something of our own in this country. So inshallah, please support it.
Yeah, can you get me fired up all over again, man? That dawah piece. And the sister said about the duas. One of the things that come to my mind, like, I pick duas over dollars any day, but we do need dollars, and dollars are also a form of dawah. Imagine, as Abla just laid out for us, I mean, if you're supporting an effort in your community and they make it to that next level and they get big, that's a reflection of our efforts in supporting them. Uh-oh, and if Marsha said it, it will get done. She said, count me in for gathering the alumni from New Jersey. So there you have it. Let's keep that thing rolling. And so we've come to our finish line. We appreciate you for coming on. We look forward to bringing you back on when you guys meet your goal. And for the next phase, whatever you got to do, we're here for you guys. And we appreciate you coming on.
Yeah, thank you all so much. We appreciate the time.
Alhamdulillah. And one last announcement. Tomorrow, same time, same channel, is our fourth Sunday. And this is the faith communities coming together around the Word of Life. We'll be back here at 7 o'clock with the members of the Folklore community as we continue to build that relationship out and forward as we dialogue about the scriptures today and how they relate to us personally, but how they relate to what's going on in today's society. So come back with us tomorrow, Sunday at 7 o'clock, same place, same channel, God willing. And we hope to see you soon. Thank you so much, Brother Morgan Mathews. Thank you so much, Sister Aidah. We will see you all soon, inshallah. And we will continue to support you in our prayers, but also support you in sharing this amazing project. Thank you so much, everyone. Peace and blessings. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Negroes in this country are confronted by is with a re-education program, not a re-education program for whites, but a re-education program for black people themselves to eliminate the negative image that has been through propaganda instilled within us of ourselves since we've been in this country. It'll take an entirely new approach to restore some kind of racial pride and racial dignity in the minds of the black people. And once we have this pride and this dignity, we can get the cohesiveness and the unity and harmony necessary to solve our own problems here in the black community instead of waiting for representatives of the white community to come uptown and solve these problems for us.
Sister Clara Muhammad, a black Muslim woman from Macon, Georgia, was an extraordinary leader and pioneer. Her contributions, especially in the development of Islamic education in America, paved the way for thousands of Muslim families to take ownership of their children's future. starting at a time when homeschooling was illegal in the United States. She eventually established a network of schools that was later named Sister Clara Muhammad Schools in her honor by her late son, Imam Warithdin Muhammad, rahimahullah. Sister Clara Muhammad helped establish the important role women had in early Muslim American history and was an inspiration to future generations of leaders. Without her, there would not have been a nation of Islam, or the unique Sunni Muslim community that evolved from it, one that was acutely aware of the concerns and aspirations of women. May Allah have mercy on Sister Clara Muhammad.
Legacy, legacy, brothers and sisters, let's celebrate. Legacy, legacy, Muslim journal, 60 years today. Legacy, legacy, our history, our perspective, our way. Legacy, legacy, Islam is our path, success away. Legacy, legacy, visit MuslimJournal.net online. Legacy, legacy, text sponsor the 999. Legacy, legacy, 999999. Legacy, legacy, MuslimJournal.net online. Legacy, legacy, brothers and sisters, let's celebrate. Legacy, legacy, Muslim journal, 60 years today. Legacy, legacy, our history, our perspective, perspective our way. Legacy, legacy, Islam is our path, success away. Legacy, legacy, visit MuslimJournal.net online. Legacy, legacy, text sponsor the 999. Legacy, legacy, 999999. Legacy, legacy, MuslimJournal.net online.
Sending love and shade of brown to you.
Say the first cutter be the one that sets the tone, to add pressure to a lesser known flesh and bone, to look different than the picture shown, and to be a rebel means you're not about to settle till you get your own. This one's for all my outside of the box thinkers, with bumblebee stingers and paper cut fingers and scrapes on their kneecaps. I know the pain lingers, the healthy way to heal a broken wing is to give it love.
Sending love in every shade.
Put a song.
I said you gotta put a song.